faculties of the psyche, that it isn't entirely confined to space and time. You can have dreams or visions of the future. You can see round corners and such things. Only ignorance deny these facts. You know, it's quite evident that they do exist and have existed always. Now these facts show that the psyche, in part at least, is not dependent upon these confinements. And then what? When the psyche is not under that obligation to live in time and space alone, and obviously it doesn't, then to that extent, the psyche is not submitted to those laws. And that means a practical continuation of life, of a sort of psychical existence beyond time and space.